Today, we're diving into the Microsoft Search configuration, and we're going to start with Answers. The Answers feature allows you to provide information to users that's not necessarily already stored in documents or other types of content. This is something you can plug directly into the configuration and spit out some cool things. The first one we're going to be covering are the acronyms. Now, this is a handy feature so that users can find what the definition of a particular acronym is. I know in my organization, we've got a slew of different acronyms. As soon as I start to learn them, they're already changing. So imagine how that applies to you and your organization and how the users feel as well. Having the ability to search for an acronym is a very powerful way to get them answered. Let's dive into how to configure these things and what the user experience looks like. We're gonna walk through the entire process, so let's get into it. Now, I'm on the Contoso site, but to configure Microsoft Search, we have to leave SharePoint and go into the M365 Admin Center. Once here, we're gonna be expanding out the menu if it isn't already expanded. We're gonna click on Show All. And then under settings, you're going to see the search and intelligence option. Here's where all the Microsoft Search things are configured. We can click on this close button to close up the little walkthrough, and you're going to immediately start to see a lot of analytics. More is going to be under insights, and we'll cover all the insights at a later date. But for now, we're going to go under the answers section, and here you'll see the acronyms. I've already got one configured for SPFX. And if I go over to the Contoso portal and if I search for SPFX, notice that it doesn't show up, but that's because my site scope is limited to this hub network, because this is a hub site. If I go up to the organization level, then you'll see that the acronym is showing up now. This is an important thing to note about Microsoft Search, is that most of these things are only going to work when you're searching at the organization level. By default, a hub site's only going to search within the hub. A home site will search everything, and all the other sites will just search within that particular site or library or list, depending on what level you're at in SharePoint. If you want to learn more about search scopes and how to change them, I've got a card up at the top, but let's keep going. So you see how there's content that's promoted above the others when it matches some of that configuration, like acronyms. You configure it back here under the acronyms section. You could have a lot of different acronyms in here that define your organization's acronyms. Let's add a new one and see how that works. Let's start with an easy one first. We'll do MRR. It stands for monthly recurring revenue. We could also put in a longer description and a source. For now, I'm just going to publish this one. And it'll take up to a day before these acronyms start to show up in your environment. So keep that in mind. And here's what it looks like after the crawl. And I could just do a simple search for what is MRR, and the acronym comes up. Another cool thing that I want to show you is that you don't have to create every acronym that you have. A lot of these can be found automatically within your environment as the search is crawling all of your data. Let me show you an example. So I don't have an acronym custom configured for ACH. However, if I go over to the search and type in ACH, then you're going to see a result here. There's an acronym that's already in here, and that's because it found that in this ACH payment collection processing document. And you'll see it right here at the top. So as content is being crawled, it's automatically looking for things like acronyms to add to the system automatically. This really cuts down the amount of acronyms you have to configure in your environment. If it's already defined in a document or other piece of content somewhere, then it's probably already going to show up. This is a big time saver for you as an administrator because you don't have to configure everything. I would start by looking to see what already shows up in your search and then just add the custom ones as needed. Some other things to note about this is that you could do bulk imports and exports of these acronyms right here using the toolbar. So if you've got another system where you maintain all of that information, it's an easy way to transform that data to the format it needs to be for this interface. And then just, you could also click on some of these items and see the history of when they were created. Any other relevant information like that, you can see that here. And obviously you can go back and edit things if information changes over time to update this thing and keep it relevant for your users. Another interesting feature is that you can exclude an acronym. and this will prevent it from being shown as an acronym in search results. You may have a situation where excluding an acronym is what you should be doing. Maybe it's internal information that doesn't need to be widely available to your users. That's a good example of when you may want to exclude that acronym from appearing to users. I'm going to keep covering all of the great features of Microsoft Search and how to configure all of this stuff. So make sure you're subscribed with a notification turned on so you know when those videos go live. And if you want more information on Microsoft Search, you can click on the playlist above.